Enjoying Life with Friends. HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Good afternoon and welcome to the Countdown studio on the very day that way back in 1966, 50 years ago, Barbados gained its independence. Of course, Barbados famous for its cricketers, its cricket, its beaches, its sunshine. I've been out there. I mean, the Caribbean is very beautiful. I've had the good fortune to be there once or twice. But I went to St. Lucia, and on some of these Leeward Islands, sort of dark side too, because while it's all beautiful for the tourists, behind the scenes, the banana farmers are slogging away for very, very, very little. And I went out on behalf of Fair Trade to try and promote the fact that if these farmers are just given just a little bit more per case of bananas, and they work so hard, in very slippery volcanic conditions, very difficult terrain, then, of course, they can have a better life, and some of the money that Fair Trade pays, and some of the big supermarkets in this country only buy Fair Trade bananas, then something else goes back into the communities. And do you know something, Rachel? None of us know what a bunch of bananas costs, so an extra penny or two makes no difference at all. What do you think? How much is a bunch of bananas?
I've no idea.
Exactly. Now, what about islands? Do you have a favourite island?
Well, I just went to Iceland recently, which was just brilliant. It's a bit of a different island to Barbados or St. Lucia, but I had a lovely time. The fish there was absolutely incredible. Went to Reykjavik, and I've got to say, it's one of the best hotspots for food I've ever been anywhere. The cuisine and the fish and the quality and everything, yeah. It's a proper foodie heaven.
Worth a trip?
Definitely worth a trip, especially if you like fish.
Good for you. Well done. All right, now, John Shaw's back with us, Rachel, from Swaddling Coat, and he's in the brewing industry, in a sense, and he's had two good victories. One was pretty close.
The last one was very close.
You know, you've done very well, John, very well. But today you're up against Lee Oman, an airline revenue analyst from Bradford. And you're a bit of a traveller. You were in Sri Lanka, I think, a couple of years ago.
Yeah, been
what
to
was
Sri Lanka.
That like?
Really nice. Some lovely hotels there. Nice coast, good food, nice people.
Yeah.
Well worth a visit.
We're very lucky that we can travel so far afield. Possibly due to the fact that your airline revenue analysis, you know, is helping us get lower flights, maybe. Who
That's
knows?
It. I keep the price down,
well
Nick.
Well done. You're a national hero. Big round of applause for Lee and John. And over in the corner, of course, Susie and the wonderful Charlotte Hawkins on her last day with us.
I know. Oh, it's been lovely. Thank you.
It's been great for us. Anyway, we'll talk to you later, and then we'll persuade you to come back soon again. Now then, John Shaw, let us go.
OK, can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, John. Start today with D.
Thank you very much. And another one.
N.
And a third, please.
S.
And a fourth.
H.
And a vowel, please.
E.
Vowel.
I.
And a vowel, please.
E.
A consonant.
L.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final V.
And here's the countdown clock. Yes, John?
Seven.
A seven, Lee?
Six.
And a six from Lee. You're six, Lee?
Devils.
Devils now, then, John?
Livened.
Livened. Charlotte?
We have another 7 of linseed.
Yep.
And there is an 8, dishevel.
Stop dishevelling your hair.
Tousling, even. All right, well done. Thank you, Charlotte. 7 points to John, and it's Lee's letters game now. Lee.
Could I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thank you, Lee. D.
And another?
T.
And a third, please?
S.
And a vowel?
O.
And another vowel, please?
I.
And a consonant, please?
R.
And another?
C.
And a vowel, please?
U.
And a consonant, please?
And the last one, P.
Stand by.
Just a 5.
A 5, John?
6.
Lee?
Pouts.
Pouts. John?
A sprout.
And sprout.
Yes. Absolutely fine.
A pouty, sprouty. Now then, Charlotte.
We had cuspid for 6, disrupt for 7, and there is an 8.
Yeah, last minute spot. You can put the OR at the end of cuspid. Cuspid is a canine tooth.
Yes.
But a cuspidor is something quite different. It's another word for a spittoon.
Really?
Yes.
We don't see those very often these days, I'm glad to say.
No, you absolutely don't.
A spittoon.
A spittoon. And there is another 8 that Rachel got over there as well.
Product.
Yeah, yes. Everyone product. Here knows I love the product for 2 primes, so.
So 13 points to John. And now it's John's numbers game. John.
Can I have 4 from the top this time, please?
You can indeed. Thank you, John. 4 large ones and 2 little ones. And for this round, 2 smalls are 4. And 5, and then the big 4, 75, 25, 100, and 50. And the target, 657.
657. Yes, John.
655. 655.
Lee.
650.
650. So we'll go with John, I think. John.
Okay, Rachel. 100 plus 50.
150.
150. Multiplied by 4.
600.
And 75 minus 25 is 50.
Yep.
Add those two together and add the 5.
655. 2 away.
2 away. Where's that missing 2? Rachel?
If you say 50 divided by 25 is 2, 75 minus 2, 73, and then 4 plus 5 is 9, and times them together, 657.
That's it. Well done. Well done. 657, as we turn to our first tea time teaser, which is Throb Set. And the clue, she's all set to marry her heartthrob. She's all set to marry her heartthrob.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Hi, Cherub.
Hi. Is that Philadelphia cheesecake? I miss you.
I miss you too.
I was talking to the cheesecake.
Nice one, Cyril. Well, hey!
check in to foxybingo.com, voted the UK's best bingo site. We've got exclusive games like Towie Bingo, plus it's jackpot o'clock, with even more to win every Friday. It's service with a five-star Fox. With over 7,000 Foxy winners every day, download the app now.
When your head is pounding, reach for Anadin Extra to relieve your headache. With a powerful combination of paracetamol, aspirin and caffeine, Anadin Extra gets to work fast in just 5 minutes to deliver effective headache relief. Oh. Anadin, stronger than pain.
Presenting the Miracle Blade Chef's Knife to cut, slice and chop all of the ingredients for your favourite dishes. The secret is this razor-sharp blade. It does the cutting for you. Unbelievable! And with a knife this sharp, you too can chop like a pro. The Miracle Blade Chef's Knife is only $12.99, exclusively at Robert Dyer's. Look out for the rest of the Miracle Blade range in-store and online now. Our incredible 12-piece knife set with bonus wall storage is now £20 off, exclusively at Robert Dyer's.
There's 50% off, five cards or more, right now at Moonpig.
Ready, steady, Christmas.
Moonpig.com.
On delicate body parts, skin is more sensitive. New Veet Sensitive Precision, the first device from Veet that gently shaves your delicate body parts. Its cutting blades don't touch the skin, so less risk of cuts and great results. Change heads to trim and shape with gentleness and precision. New Veet Sensitive Precision.
Oh, hello. It's Debenhams Beautiful Gifts Week. Beauty and fragrance have up to 15% off. Now on and Sunday.
This Christmas, you can shop when it suits you with Boots Order and Collect. Order online by 8 p.m. and collect free at your nearest store from 12 p.m. the next day.
Are you 65 or over? Cold weather can make you more likely to catch a winter illness that could become very serious. But there are things you can do to stay well this winter.
Make sure you get your free flu jab.
And if you start to feel unwell, even if it's just a cough or a cold, get help from your pharmacist before it gets more serious.
We're all here to help you stay well this winter.
Us. Fragrance for Men by Paco Rabanne.
It's Alan Carr's Happy Hour, a brand new show filled with celebrity guests, audience surprises and stunts.
Then I zip wire down and that's the advert.
No, this is the advert.
What?
Alan Carr's Happy Hour, Friday at 8 on Channel 4.
Can I keep the dough?
No.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Welcome back. I left you with the clue. She's all set to marry her heartthrob. And the answer is betrothed. Betrothed. Now, 20 points to John. Lee yet to score. Plenty of time, Lee. Now it's your letters game.
I can have a consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Lee. T.
And a vowel.
A.
And another consonant, please.
R.
And another, please.
S.
Consonant.
W.
And a vowel.
O.
Consonant.
R.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, L.
Countdown.
Six.
A six, John?
Seven.
And a seven. Lee?
Worcester.
Waster and?
Roaster.
And a roaster?
Yes, absolutely fine.
A roaster. Yeah, Charlotte.
So there is wastrel for seven.
Yes.
Good word, that.
And there is an eight.
Yes.
Realtors.
Realtors.
We allowed that. It's an American.
Yes, Americanism. Estate, but it's in the dictionary.
Yeah. Realtor.
Realtors.
OK. And a wastrel. That's a great word.
It is good.
Such a wastrel. 27 points. Well done. John, it's your letters game now.
All right, Rachel, can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, John. T.
And a consonant?
H.
And a third, please.
R.
A vowel?
A.
Another vowel?
O.
A consonant, please.
B.
Another consonant?
C.
A vowel?
A.
And a consonant, please.
And lastly, T.
Stand by. Yes, John?
Five.
A five, Lee?
Five.
Thank you, John.
Botch.
Botch.
Batch.
And batch, why not? Batch, botch. Charlotte?
There is a six, brooch, and there is a seven.
Yes?
Acrobat.
Oh, that's good. Acrobat, well done. Acrobat. Great word. 32 to Lee's five, and it's Lee's numbers game now. Lee?
Two large, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Lee. Two from the top row. And four little ones this time. And your four small ones are 9, 6, 1 and 8. And the big two, 25 and 50. And the target, 448.
448. Yes, Lee?
449.
One away. How about John?
448.
448. Slap bang in the middle. And?
OK, 50 times 9.
50 times 9, 450.
8 minus 6 is 2.
Yep.
And take it away.
448, lovely.
Well done. Very good. Well done, John. Good, good score there. 42 and Lee on 5, but this time. Quite a lot of time. Now then, Charlotte, what's it like working on Good Morning Britain with somebody who has the reputation of being sort of bad boy of British broadcasting?
Yeah, so I think the second most commonly asked question I get after people ask me what time I get up in the morning, they all say, what is it like working with Piers Morgan? I think it's safe to say there hasn't been a dull moment since he arrived on the Good Morning Britain sofa. Most people do compare him to that well-known breakfast spread in that he's either loved or hated in pretty much equal measure. For Susanna Reid and I, working alongside him, quite frankly, we are most of the time lucky to get a word in edgeways.
Yes.
The only time he's quiet is when he's looking at Twitter to check the latest hornet's nest that he's managed to stir up online. Mm. So I think it's, yeah, he has ruffled a few feathers. He's certainly livened things up along the way. And I find it fascinating because I can see all the guests as they come into the studio. And with the politicians, for example, you see them coming in, quite a few of them, with this look of trepidation, sometimes even dread on their face as they do that walk towards the sofa. Mm. And then some of them do leave looking reasonably shell-shocked on the way out as well. He certainly doesn't pull any punches. And even our showbiz guests who, you know, might be expecting a bit more of an easy ride. We had Al Murray, the pub landlord, come in the other day and he had to be forcibly dragged into the studio shouting, "No, not Piers Morgan." I think that was for comedy purposes, but, you know, you just never know. And recently, Piers went to interview the Dalai Lama. So So Susanna and I were thinking, great, you know, this is the world's most spiritual, compassionate and wise man. Surely some of this is going to rub off on Piers when he goes to meet him. But Piers posted this picture on Twitter of the two of them together. Yeah. And the Dalai Lama seemed to be doing this to Piers. And I thought, no, the reverse has happened. You know, this is the most compassionate and caring man, and he's pushed him to the brink. He's finally snapped in the face of extreme provocation. And when I said to Piers, what was he doing? What had you said that had annoyed him that much? And Piers said that the Dalai Lama was doing the compassionate thing and was actually helping him out by holding one of his chins in.
Very good. Thank you very much. Well done. Very good. Now then, John, your letters came.
Have a consonant, please.
Thank you, John. Y.
And another consonant.
D.
Third.
T.
And fourth, please.
R.
A vowel.
I.
Another vowel, please.
E.
And a third.
U.
A consonant.
N.
And a vowel, please.
And the last one, O.
Stand by. John?
Seven.
Seven, Lee?
Six.
And that six?
Rotund.
Rotund.
And untried.
And untried indeed, all right.
Yeah, very good.
Charlotte and Susie?
A few words on a bit of a theme here. There's rude, dirty, nudity, all in a row. And there is an eight, routined.
Routined, indeed. Well done. Thank you, Charlotte. So, Lee, your letters game.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Lee. G.
And another.
T.
And a third, please.
M.
And a vowel.
I.
And another vowel, please.
A.
And a consonant.
B.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
D.
And another consonant, please.
And the last one, F.
Stand by.
Just a five.
A five, John?
A six.
And a six. Lee?
Gamed.
Gamed and?
Gambit.
And gambit.
Yes, absolutely fine, both gamed. Fine, there is a verb. Yeah.
Gambit. Now, Charlotte, Susie?
There is a seven.
Yes.
Megabit, as in computer terminology.
Yes, unit of data size.
Yeah.
A million bits, or strictly speaking, a little bit more than that.
Yeah.
But yes, seven's for us, Nick.
Thank you. All right. So, John, numbers. How about a numbers game?
Can I have four from the top, please, and two small?
Thank you, John. Four large and two little ones coming up. And these two little are three and nine. And the big four, 75, 100, 50, and 25. And this target, 422.
422.
Thank you.
Yes, John.
422.
Thank you, Lee.
422.
Thank you. John.
OK, 50 minus 3.
50 minus 3, 47.
Multiplied by 9.
Multiplied by 9 is 423.
And then 75 add 25 is 100.
Yep.
And divide that by the other 100 to get the 1 and take it away.
Lovely. 422.
Well done. And Lee?
9 times 50.
450.
Minus 25.
Yep. 45.
Minus 3.
Perfect. Well done. 422 again.
Thank you very much. There we go. From 65 plays 15 as we turn to our second tea time teaser, which is he carped. And the clue, he carped on speaking pompously to everybody. He carped on speaking pompously to everybody.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Want to stay young but hate the heavy feel of creams? Olay Total Effects Featherweight. Fight 7 signs of aging in one lightweight, quick-absorbing moisturiser. The 7-in-1 from the world's number one. Now Featherweight. Skin doesn't have to show your age. Olay. Ageless. And this Christmas, get a free Olay gift exclusively at Boots when you spend £20 on Olay.
Homebase makes Christmas decorating easy with a huge range at always low prices. Like this Nordman fir Christmas tree, only £20. This 7-foot Montana artificial Christmas tree, just £15. And these 240 warm white LED string lights, just £12. Homebase, always low prices.
I'm Elaine Page, and this is my personal selection of the very best of the musicals. Three CDs of my all-time favourites from hit shows like Aladdin, yes, love, Aspects of Love, Wicked, Beautiful, Cats, and Chess. Elaine Page presents the musicals. Out now.
Matt has gotten used to the funk in his living room. Yes, he's gone nose blind. He thinks it smells fine, but his wife smells this. Luckily for your hard-to-wash fabrics, there's Febreze Fabric Refresher. Because Febreze doesn't just mask, it truly eliminates odours and leaves a light, fresh scent. Use Febreze till it's fresh and breathe happy.
This Christmas, make the most of those special moments with Photobox. And make someone's Christmas. Take it, make it, Photobox it.
The Strutters saved on their car insurance and now they feel epic. Strutters, your so money supermarket.
Missed Black Friday? Lidl's is this Thursday. We've got a Yamaha keyboard for only $69.99. A ukulele for $14.99. And this electric drum set for $49.99. No silent night this Christmas, then. From Thursday the 1st of December, every little thing for Christmas.
From butchers to bakers, to tailors and makers. From first light to late at night. It's your local shops that'll see you right. So let's get out there and help our high streets thrive. Shop small and make a big difference. Join Small Business Saturday on the 3rd of December. American Express. Realize the potential.
New Christmas collection, available at Swarovski stores and Swarovski.com.
Whoa!
Oh!
I put a spell on you.
I don't believe it.
Stop the things you do.
Say no, say no.
Oh, dear, dear, dear.
Spellbinding Telly, Fridays at 9 on Channel 4.
HSL, the chair specialists, sponsors of Countdown.
Welcome back. I left with a clue. He carped on, speaking pompously to everybody. And the answer is that he preached. 65 to 15, Johnny in the lead, and it's Lee's letters game. Lee.
Continent, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Lee. S.
And another, please.
F.
And another.
K.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And another vowel, please.
O.
And a consonant, please.
N.
And a vowel, please.
I.
A consonant.
L.
And a consonant.
And lastly, P.
Stand by. Yes, Lee.
Six.
A six, John?
Six.
Lee.
Fusion.
And
flunks.
Thank you. We happy, Susie?
Yes. Just to double check flunk, but I think it will be in yes. It's fine. To
flunk
fail
an exam.
Yeah.
Yeah. Charlotte.
There is a seven. If someone's had a good night out, they may have had this. A skinful.
Indeed. Indeed. Anything else?
No, that was there for
a
seven.
A skinful, quite enough. All right. So, 71 to 21, and it's John's letters game now. John.
A consonant, please.
Thank you, John. T.
And another one, please.
N.
And a third.
J.
And a fourth.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And another vowel.
A.
And a third, please.
O.
A consonant.
G.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final W.
And here's the countdown clock.
A risky seven.
All right, Lee.
Six.
You're six?
Agents.
Agents. Now then, John.
Stowage.
Oh. Yes, not risky, certainly not in countdown terms. In the dictionary, the action of stowing something or space for stowing something in, originally, I think, the payment that you would pay on board a boat. But either way, or anyway, it's fine for seven.
Very good. Well done, John. And Charlotte?
No, it couldn't beat another seven. Just got another one, which is tangos.
Tangos. All right. Of course, it takes two to tango. 78 plus 21. Now then, Susie, your wonderful origins of words. And today...
Well, today I'm going to hopefully answer a question that Rachel put to me the other day, which is where does an Indian summer come from? A little bit late in the year now for an Indian summer, but we all love them at the time of unseasonably warm, dry weather that usually comes in sort of early, even late autumn sometimes. It reached England in the 19th century, and that was the heyday of the British Raj in India. So most people then thought it must have something to do with the Indian subcontinent. In fact, it doesn't. It has everything to do with Native Americans, so North American Indians, who used this term for a late flowering, if you like, in terms of farming, harvesting, and it also slipped rather nicely figuratively into language. So it would be a late bloom, and one poet beautifully talked about the Indian summer of the heart, which I think is rather lovely. Mm. But there's one quote from indeed somebody who was farming in America, the North American Indian community, who describes it thus. He says, then a severe frost succeeds, which prepares it to receive the voluminous coat of snow, which is soon to follow, though it is often preceded by a short interval of smoke and mildness, called the Indian summer. So again, rather beautiful description. Incidentally, over in Britain, we called it something else. We called it St. Luke's summer or St. Martin's summer, or even All Hallowed summer. So we had a different word for it. None of those really stuck around, and we in turn then so often adopted the Americanism and Indian summer. But quite why it's called an Indian summer, there's been lots of conjectures, really. We know that certainly in North American Indian communities, they called it thus. But quite why it caught on, no one knows for sure, but there have been lots of theories. One is that it was more common in their territories than anywhere else. The second is, as I say, they harvested their crops at that time. Others believed it was caused by prairie fires, which set off this sort of haziness over the horizon and caused the appearance of a beautiful warm day. But sadly, the truth, I think, lies closer to something which is rather unpleasant, and that is in those days, anything Indian was seen as being slightly inferior. The ersatz version, if you like, of the real thing. So people thought an Indian summer wasn't the real thing, it was just a sort of a little pretend summer that came along a little bit later on. So not quite as poetic as the other theories, but that doesn't stop us all wanting an Indian summer.
Absolutely. Wow. Every year we yearn for an Indian summer, having had a rotten summer. Although this year, in fact, was a great summer.
It was.
With an Indian summer.
Exactly.
So there we are. 78 to 21, John's in the lead, and it's Lee's letters game. Lee.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thank you, Lee. P.
And another.
L.
And a third, please.
M.
Vowel.
I.
And another.
E.
And another, please.
U.
A consonant,